What's up, everyone? It's Stray Dog. Remember this?
What's your name?
Oh, don't worry about it.
Well, he had filed a privacy complaint against me, so I done a little video about that the other day. And I had reached out to San Joaquin Valley Transparency and High Desert Community Watch, and they both got back to me pretty quick. Thanks, guys, for that. And I talked to High Des on the phone, and I wanted to ask him because I knew I was legal, you know, and stuff. It's just that I wanted to make sure that there wasn't something I was overlooking. You know, I know they had already gone through this probably a few times over, so I was just being, you know, better safe than sorry and stuff. So, you know, he confirmed, yeah, dude, don't worry about it, you're good, you're legal. And just when I respond to, you know, be polite and stuff and thank him for letting me respond and just let him know who I was, what I was doing there. And that's what I did. I thanked him for the opportunity to respond and who I was and stuff. I'm not going to bore you with the paragraph I wrote them, but anyways, they responded back and said, hello, we have reviewed the complaint and have determined that the content is exempted from removal based on our privacy guidelines. The content does not violate our policies and will remain on the site. We thank you for using YouTube. So there it is. Patterson, he came at me all wrong from the beginning, man. I mean, look at your body language. Not much room out here to begin with, but you push through and walk ahead of him and come at me like you're gonna exert some authority, you know, and then you do this.
Oh, don't worry about it.
I mean, come on, man, that's not how you treat the public. You know, that's why you became the center of attention in this whole story. And then you go and try and be smart and do a privacy complaint against me, which is why we're here the second time, and you're the center of attention. I mean, I didn't even have to talk to you. I didn't have to say a single word to you. But I afforded you that opportunity for a small conversation, and you screwed that up. That's why I walked away. Had you been cordial, stayed polite, been cool, I would have kept talking to you and told you a little more. And I would have highlighted you guys for being professional. But instead, you ruined it, man, and brought this on yourself. Let me tell you something, dude. You're a federal employee. Your name, your badge number, where you work, their phone number, it's all public information. And you're in public. You have no expectation of privacy, whether you're in uniform or not. And while you're in uniform, you're working for the people. You're a public servant. You're paid by our tax dollars. We the people expect you to be professional the entire time you're in that uniform or while on duty, period. That is not how you represent your company, the people, the security company, the security thing. You made all your security guards look like assholes. The general public is gonna think because of your actions that all of you are like that, when in fact it might only be you. You disgraced your company with that attitude, man. You should have came out cool. I would have been cool with you. I had no intentions of trying to embarrass you. I would have loved to highlight you guys and say, this is the guys that are working here. They did an excellent job. You would have got props from all my viewers. But instead, you had to be a jerk, man. You did this to yourself. I hope you don't get mad. I hope you take this as a humbling experience and help make yourself a better person. We've got enough eagles and pricks running around this country, man. We don't need any more. So I'm going to pretend that you want to thank me and Google for the clarification, so I'm gonna go ahead and click this for you. Thank you for the clarification. All on your behalf. So anyways, that's that, guys, and thanks for watching. One more thing, I'd like to dedicate this little victory to my dog, Bruce. His full name is Bruce Lee. My daughter named him. We lost him the other day to cancer, and you know, he was my boy. He went everywhere with me. He rode shotgun with me. He was my ride or die partner. My daughter had him since she was 4 or 5 years old. He was well trained. I could walk all over town with him without being on the leash. I go in the store, he'd wait outside, and he was just the best dog, and we lost him the other day. And so I'd like to dedicate this to you, Bruce. I love you, boy. I'll see you on the other side. Thanks, guys.